everyone, Action Movie Dad here, and you're looking great today. Today we've got a very short video and a very cheap trick. Free, in fact. Nate Level from NT Productions and I put together a free downloadable script that I call 3D Plane Stamp. In short, it's a one-click way to project the texture of your footage onto any 3D solid. So, let's get stamping. In lots of visual effects work, it's helpful to use the handy solids that you can create with the After Effects Camera Tracker. They are great guides for placing 3D layers, but I've always wished that I could see the texture of the footage here instead of just a solid color. I did a very complicated demonstration of one way you could approximate this in my Onward tutorial, and I wish I had thought of this then. Technically, once you create a plane on a surface, the way a camera projection should work is like this. The footage from the camera's perspective should be what is projected onto that guide solid from that perspective. One in After Effects way to grab that info would be with the CC Power Pin tool, by placing the four points exactly at the four corners of your solid, and then checking the unstretch option, giving you something like this. Now for precision, instead of eyeballing it, you could use a 2-comp expression to grab the exact screen location of those four corner points, and then unstretch. Now save this texture, and then re-import it, and make it a 3D card with the exact same placement, scale, and rotation of that guide solid. But that's a lot of steps, and who has the time? That's why Nate Lovell from NT Productions was awesome enough to write this lovely script that does all that when you simply click on this nifty button. Over on Nate's YouTube channel, you can learn a whole bunch about creating your own After Effects scripts. You can watch side by side as he works on these scripts and puts them together, and that's why I reached out to Nate, because I love the way he simplifies some of these complex processes. And now this saint has put together this lovely free script that you can download from the link below, and place it right into your After Effects Script UI Panels folder. It's under Support Files, Scripts, then Script UI Panels. Placing it here will make it a nice, dockable panel that's very minimal to snap right into your interface if you like. Next, be sure to go to your After Effects Preferences, down to Scripting and Expressions, and check the box that says Allow Scripts to Write Files. And now the script is ready to go. Load in some footage, and then do your 3D tracking, and create guide solids on any surface that you might want to stamp the textures from. At this stage, I always recommend using our other free script called Normalize Track, so your 3D data is centered and aligned. Now scrub to the frame that you want to sample your textured area from, and highlight the solid you desire. You can also scale the solid to whatever space you want covered, and use the gizmos to align it if there are any straight lines you kind of want preserved. I would add a little bit of slop to the side, just in case. Make sure your layer is still highlighted, and then press the stamp button. You'll see that the script shows you the texture that it's about to export, exports it, and then brings it in as a 3D layer with the same transform properties as your selected solid. It also hides the solid that was there, so you're already ready to go. The exported PNG saves in the same directory as your project file and is named after your solid layer, with a random 4-digit number to avoid any potential overwrite issues. You can do this as many times as you want through your comp. And obviously it's just a flat plane, so it'll look pretty good throughout your comp if your surface is flat, or if the parallax is minimal. Content-aware fill could do a pretty good job at painting out a character in many cases like this, especially with more organic surfaces and backgrounds. But I found that sometimes there's a bit of warpiness or blendiness that happens when you're using something like a brick wall or something with straight lines. And honestly, nothing's stopping you from combining content-aware fill and the stamper to get a great result. You could also go as crazy as you want. For example, here's me running the stamper on a handful of planes in this tracked stock footage. And check out the result. Basically, we've created a 3D card version of that stock footage. And if you want, you could ditch the camera data and do whatever you wanted. Since these are just simple flat layers, you could pre-comp them and work right in After Effects to add signage or weathering in a very manageable way. As another bonus, since these are just true 3D cards in After Effects, they'll interact with any of your other 3D layers perfectly. And even if you don't have 3D tracking data, you could just pull in a photo, add a camera, roughly line some solid planes to kind of line up with it, and then stamp all of those textures into a neat 2.5D comp with pretty minimal effort. One caution when using the stamper, it's best if the majority of your stamping plane is within the shot. Since the texture has to be corner pin transformed, you really want the best resolution for your texture possible, and it's possible that you'll get an incorrect unstretched result if the points are way outside the boundaries of your frame. If you happen to be a regular viewer of our show VFX and Chill,
is this what you were creating the button for this week?
I'm trying to create a free script for you all that'll just do this.
This is brilliant, dude. I'm excited to see this.
We've actually sent out the link to this script a few times before. And thanks to the help of some wonderful viewers, we found out that sometimes if you're working with a very high quality comp with a large color depth or an extra high resolution, sometimes the script wasn't finishing. And that's because one of the middle steps of this is exporting a PNG and then re-importing it to the same spot. Sometimes the read-write time of that takes a little bit extra long. So if you're experiencing this, go ahead and check this little HQ delay button, which will simply add a time delay to that read-write moment, which hopefully gets this script working perfectly for you. If you're like me and just getting to know Cinema 4D and more comfortable in After Effects, you could always export one of your After Effects projects directly into Cinema with the export tool. It'll come into Cinema like this, with the animated camera and the planes with the textures on them already. If you want, you can simply add a background object with the original footage as its material, and now you have a handy reference for exactly what you're creating. Now, especially if you're making something reflective, I think this is a really nice low-rent way to have a floor object with the correct texture on it and stuff. Now, remember, this is cheap tricks, and there are, of course, a lot of more accurate and proper ways to do all of these 3D kind of things. In fact, you could learn the bulk of them right now on Cineversity or on the Maxon Training Team channel. You can always reach out to me or any member of the Maxon Training Team online or even live during one of our daily shows and get an answer right there. But if you don't need any of that right now, just take the free script and, you know, use it to erase the top half of your body. Or, you know, even better, use it for something that I haven't even thought of yet. There's a bunch of stuff that I would love to still enhance this script with, and there are also probably a bunch of parts of your After Effects workflow that could be enhanced by a script. What are some of the most common and repetitive tasks that you do in After Effects that you would love to have a script for? Let me know in the comments below. Said like an experienced YouTuber. And really, that's it. That's all I got. Enjoy the rest of your day.